If you could ask yourself one question, what would you ask yourself?
If I could ask myself one question, I really love the question of, you know, what when you first pick up these new tools, what's your first reaction? I do a podcast called AI Frontiers, and I love asking people in the computing research, various computing research fields, this question, because universally people are surprised, whether they're coming from, you know, straight up computer science or human machine interaction, or even some discipline like law or something else. There's always an aspect of, wow, I didn't think I would live to see a machine do that. And so I love learning about that first reaction. And then typically there's a process, right? From that first reaction of surprise, maybe there's a range of emotions that goes along with it. You know, these moments always cause us to reflect on our worth in some way as a person. But then you really get to a point where you realize, oh, okay, I see how I could use this. And by the way, I see that it's got these capabilities, but it's also got some limitations, and I have ideas for how I can improve what it can do or use it in a new way. So I love really seeing people's journeys with the technology, and I have my own. So I guess if I were interviewing me, I would ask about my own journey.
That's funny. I can tell you my reaction, which is, as a screenwriter, I really thought the robots would come for me last. I did not think that it would be number one. But
in my career, I've had the opportunity to do sonar engineering. And what this means is, at least what I was doing, was the application of specialized machine learning to the detection and classification of underwater sound, sound originated from sources underwater. And one of the first things I did with GPT-4 was I actually wanted to see how good of a sonar engineer it could be. Why? Because I knew for a fact that it wasn't trained to be a sonar engineer or anything to do with sonar engineering. So I thought it'd be a kind of a good first case to see, again, how general is this thing? And I asked it a very underspecified question. I said, you know, if a sound is produced in the ocean, how far away could I hear that sound? It's a very underspecified question, because you have to know a lot of things. And what surprised me about the answer was the degree to which the model could fill in, you know, the generations of the model looked to me like reasoning whereby the machine was filling in the blanks. Well, first I need to know what frequency is the sound. Is it high pitch? Is it low pitch? Because different sounds with different frequency content, you know, that will affect how they travel through the water. But so let's assume this is the machine now. Let's assume this frequency. I also need to know something about the source level of the sound. How loud is the sound, right? That's going to have an impact on how far it travels. Let's assume this source level. I also have to have an understanding of the listening device. How are you listening? By the way, it's actually more effective if you have a multi-channel listening device. That is multiple hydrophones picking up the sound, because you can get more gain that way. So let's assume an array. Like, this is all in the response, right? And so I found it very surprising. And I didn't even, if I were really doing sonar engineering work, I would have checked, and then it gave an answer after all those assumptions. And I actually didn't care so much whether the answer was numerically correct, because I know once you can set up the problem, I know we have computational tools that can solve the problem, but the reasoning in setting up the problem was what I was most impressed by. And so that was my first interaction, or one of my first interactions, and really the beginning of a journey of exploration into, well, what is this thing really capable of? What are the limitations? Where are we in this progression of AI technologies? And where should we go next?